dick out.
Whipped out the dick.
Head of the glory.
Oh, oh. My new obsession is baby wipes. I love them.
Yeah.
Not even for like cleaning purposes, like I have the buttocks.
Mm-hmm.
I just love them. It's my substitute because I always feel like I have shit on my hands. Mm-hmm. So I just did a little baby wipe spritz. I cleaned my hands, I cleaned my mouth off because I just drank some beer.
I sometimes use baby wipes as like a makeup remover.
Yeah.
Like on my face.
I scraped my elbow the other day and I had some dry down blood in it. Do you know what that baby wipe did? It got rid of the blood. So if you ever kill a hooker, you know what to do. I don't know what happened over the weekend. I chafed my dick. I got my dick so raw, I had to put lotion on it. Like, it was awful.
Dang, you had a busy weekend.
I had a busy weekend. It was awesome. I was very proud of myself. 4 times.
Wow.
In the matter of 2 days.
Wow.
I was really proud of myself because I came on Saturday, and then 10 minutes, I went downstairs and I got, I don't know what I did, I ate something or I don't even know what I did. It was like 10 minutes later, I was like, I want to do it again. So I just did it again 10 minutes later. I'm so proud of myself. I'm like, I have good stamina.
Mm-hmm.
I can shoot off like a fucking rocket.
Mm-hmm.
Awesome. Awesome.
Awesome.
Awesome.
Awesome.
I love spraying all over. It's so fun.
That's gross.
Here's me last night. Oof. Shooting off my ludes.
Are you a squirter?
I thought that was funnier.
A shooter?
I am a spurter.
Spurter?
Yeah. It dribbles and it spurts.
It sounds like chunky.
Yeah, it's not. No, it's not chunky. It's, it's like that. No, it's, it will shoot a little bit, but it's not, because if you dribble all the way, if you just like ooze, there's something wrong with you. It's not that. It's not just like a, you know, but it's a little bit of a.
Okay.
It's like that. It's like a little, like a small fart. Just a little bit.
Mm.
This is me last night. And the first time I did it, I did the thing where you when you're about to come, you put your hands up, and you just go. But I did the thing where I was jerking off and I stopped myself and I just let myself come by myself. I had a whole fun time. I experimented with myself. I just had fun, you know.
Yeah.
You gotta have fun.
I get it.
You gotta have fun. What else are you gonna do on the weekend? What did you do? What was your weekend? I don't think we've ever asked each other what we've done on the weekend.
We don't know what the other does like during the week at all.
I don't
except
ask.
For Monday
from
10 to 1:30, 2 o'clock.
I want to imagine you don't do anything else. All I want is
I work. I mean, no. Over the weekend.
I wish you didn't. I wish this was all you did. I know I don't pay you enough to do it, but I wish this was all you did.
I wish to.
Amazing.
Let's see.
Saturday. Do you think you could do this like 4 or 5 days a week? I think you could.
Oh, yeah.
I think you'd be begrudging about it. You'd be like, oh, I hate this. But I think it would translate well to the air. Your mic's real close, by the way. I'm hearing
Sorry.
Jonathan, do you hear that? It's amazing. Move it up.
Up.
Yeah.
Like that?
Yeah. Try breathing a little. I'll know in a second. Oh, I hear it still.
Well, that was like really loud, though.
Yeah, that was dramatic. Yeah. I don't mind it up there.
I don't want to mic my nostril though, like Hunter did.
No, as long as it's pointed down. It's not. I'm not hearing it. The nostril. I love the show. The show does more technical. This is a show perfect for people learning to do broadcasting. anything we do, don't do. No, because I'm hearing it hit the mic. See, listen.
Is it hitting the mic now?
Well, no, because the air's hitting it. It's not the actual sound of it. It's the air hitting the thing. Air is the enemy of everything.
Oh, got you. Anyway,
what did you do over the weekend?
What the hell did I do? Saturday.
Are you surprised I still cared after? I usually will skip, and I like we did this there. I asked you a question, then we got on. Usually I don't care. I don't care what happened, but I actually still do care. So go on.
Saturday morning, I went to a band practice, and then Saturday afternoon.
Who's band? Why are you involved in so much, Tori?
It was for a church band.
Oh, no.
And then I went to sushi with my friends, and then I went to work.
Why do you have to practice for a church band, though? I feel like if people are going to church, they really don't care how shitty the music is.
No, the music's the best part.
Well, I'm just saying I wouldn't
if
like...
If the music's not good, then the service isn't good.
Ooh.
But in, at like, least that's my You like a good opinion. Servicing? Anyways, then I went to sushi, and then I went to work, and then on Sunday I went to church, and then I did bowling with my family.
Mm-hmm.
Football bowling. Have you heard of that?
Tori, what kind of services do you offer?
Do you need a massage?
We have 40 new Tori sound effects. This is one of them. Hold on, I'll pot it up. I'm going to put more pot on this in my backyard.
Do you need a massage?
I love that. Do you need a massage? There's so many of them. Oh,
and then Hunter's mom's boyfriend just got out of a pool, and it's finally finished. So we went and...
Hunter in the pool is just amazing.
And then we went and swam in his pool. So it was a pretty full weekend.
Do people know who Hunter is?
Hunter is my boyfriend.
Come in my burger.
Oh my god, yes.
It's the first Hunter sound effect.
Come in my burger.
Hey, don't awesome. Laugh, don't laugh too quick.
Come in my burger.
We have matching, so instead of wedding vows, you say, will you take the man and wife, and instead of an ID, you'll just say,
come in my burger.
Come in my burger.
Everyone must die.
Oh, fuck, everything's coming. Sorry. I wonder if I can play those at the same time.
Hold on. I want you to make Ryan sound effects.
We pull them, but I don't want them.
Why?
Because.
Come in my burger.
I'm not trying to fuck your
Oh, fuck. Sorry. All right, never mind. Forget what I just said. Forget what you just said.
Apparently, Ryan doesn't know how to.
I don't. No, I put a thing on there so it doesn't. It will stop. It gives me like 2 seconds to stop it. Mm-hmm. But then I forgot about it. That's
Everyone must die.
But that one didn't have it. That was the problem. I see. I finally added it.
Come in my burger.
I have a second to catch it. Because I like to have them autoplay, because mm-hmm. sometimes it's just so I just have fun. Especially with the Oz, you got to do autoplay with those. Oh, yeah, Air Bud mixed in with that. So I was going to say Air Bud.
Air Bud!
All right, sorry. let's just start the show again. Okay. So over the weekend, Hunter was in a pool, which amazes me. The thinking, the thought process of Hunter in the pool is amazing.
Why?
Because he's just like a big baby, and I love it. Like, he's kind of like half dog, half human.
Yeah. Actually, I really agree with it.
So Hunter enjoys the pool?
Mm-hmm.
Come in my burger.
Good for him, though. Glad he likes the pool. I felt like you're on a roll, then I asked you what you did this weekend. So that's what you did this weekend.
Yeah, what did you do? Other than jerk off four times?
I jerked off four times in a row. And I knew I shouldn't have done it, too, because I was like, you're going to exhaust yourself, too.
And like the thing is, you don't like... You're asleep, I feel like, for
most of the day. I'm like a cat.
So, like, that's not a lot of time. Like,
it's a lot of wasted time masturbating. I agree. Now, I just feel like it's going to kill me. Like, I'm just going to have a heart attack jerking off one day.
Just please don't, like, die jerking off because you accidentally strangled yourself to death.
No, it won't be that. I get vigorous with it. It's amazing. I have so much fun. See, I'm always, like, I always want to, there's so many things I want to express to the show, but it's like sometimes you have to, you know, mm-hmm. you don't get too much into your sex mm-hmm. life, but
really,
but I have, what to say, I
feel like we really do.
Well, I want to explain why I get so exhausted. I have an apparatus where you can mount it to like to something. Let's refer to it as a mountable fleshlight. So you actually have to do physical activity.
Oh, okay.
Which is so yeah. So I'm actively and I did that four times.
So I
simulatedly banged. Four times.
Mm.
But that involves the thrusting. It's amazing.
Mm.
I get into it. I get good practice. Because I feel like I'm horrible. I just come in like 2 seconds. So mm-hmm. It's nice to have the actual...
So you need to practice.
We get the whole body involved. Mm-hmm. And Jonathan, do you own fleshlights? Do you own anything like that? It's like Jonathan, being a gay man, would be like, I got experience with a butthole.
Actually, I do not.
Why not, though? I was going to ask you, too, should we... I'd have you give it to her, but would you like to give Jessica a vibrator for her last day?
Oh my God, no.
No, come on.
Oh my God, no. I don't want her to feel uncomfortable.
What if I have Amazon logged in on this computer? If I do, I know I can just do it on my phone, but I don't.
I've tried to like,
Can I get you? I want to get you, get it the same vibrator I got you. But I was going to buy it for her, but I was like, that's disgusting. That's my cousin. But I also think it'd be so funny if I bought my cousin a vibrator.
Oh my
but
God.
I think, I feel like she'd enjoy it though, because she has a boyfriend and she's up at school. And, I'm so shocked that Jonathan doesn't have anything that he fucks. Jonathan, you've never bought something like that? Have you ever been to a sex store? I feel like Jonathan, didn't you tell me you bought something?
I've
like,
never been to a sex
store. I think Jonathan told me...
I have at one time bought something, but then
Did you say you bought edible panties or something?
No,
is
not me.
Is that you?
Me.
Who am I thinking of? Who the fuck in my life do I know bought edible panties? Is that you?
No.
Someone I know bought edible underwear and it like stuck to the person. Yeah.
So. Ugh.
Jonathan,
was that Katie?
No, I don't think so, Katie.
Was it Chloe? No.
Was it Chloe? No, Chloe's not like that. Chloe's not sexual at all.
Was it Brett?
No. Again, why are you naming the least sexual people on this show?
I don't know.
Well, they've ever done the show.
I'm trying to think of who's been on the show.
Who has sex, said sex 0 to 1 times? And those are both Chloe and Brett. I think a combined sexual encounters between Brett and Chloe are about 2. I think Brett might have broken up. I can't tell, though. He's back to posting emotional
probably
things.
Probably Betsy had some.
Maybe it was her. I think it was her.
Oh, yeah. That sounds like
Betsy sounds like
thing.
She'd do that. What are you doing over there, by the way? Oh, sorry. You opened up your Pellegrino.
Yeah.
She's like,
just getting it ready.
I thought you were getting like lotion in your hands. I heard a bunch of noise over there. I'm sorry. So, Jonathan, you've never... So what did you buy from the sex store? You said you bought something.
Let me think.
How do you not remember?
It was just like a anal toy.
Oh my goodness. For you or a friend?
For me.
Something you insert?
Yeah.
Oh, he's so cute, isn't he?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Adorable, yeah.
Meanwhile, he's shoving shit up his ass.
Meanwhile, we're not actually seeing him shove shit up his ass.
He's sitting on it right now.
it's a sound Jonathan makes. The coin collect sound.
No, I've tried to convince Hunter to like.
Why are you veering away from Jonathan?
Because we're talking about like fleshlights and sex toys.
All right, go on, but we have to go back
and
to
this. He's like not interested, and I don't understand why.
And we'll come back to that. Jonathan, so what did you buy for yourself?
Anal beads.
I just told you.
An anal bead? That's extreme, anal beads. Like, not just
were,
a... Was it a...
Like a... I don't know. Kind of like beads, but they weren't... Like, just a plastic...
It was a butt plug, right? With, like, a little ridges, right?
Yeah, but it was longer, so yeah.
Than a butt plug? Well, how long is a butt plug?
I thought they were really short.
It ranges.
I love Tori. That Tori's a fucking expert. So how big would you say? Because it's listed on the package how much it is. It's you know, this, you know, 7-inch or 4.5-inch. Mm-hmm. How big was it? You still have
it? I think
it
was like, oh, yeah.
See, exactly, he doesn't still use it.
Yeah, I do.
So how do you not know all the information? Go grab it.
I'm on a trip this week. I'm not home.
You're not? You didn't bring it with you?
No.
It's not that special of a toy, then. Thank God Jonathan's back, by the way. So... The thing is, how long would you say compared to, like, another object? Like, compared to your phone, what phone do you have, the iPhone 7?
Plus.
Okay, so you have a 5.5-inch phone. How big is it compared to the screen size of your iPhone 7 Plus?
You want to know how long it is.
Yeah,
right?
Well, I want more Jonathan, of a, like, I want more of a description. I'm still not sure what we're talking about here.
Come on, we got to get...
Are we talking about a butt plug, or are we talking about something
else? Tori, I have an hour to kill. What do you think else we're going to talk about? Slow your roll, Tori. Tori wants to know what's the link. Is it on Amazon? Is it
Prime? It's probably like 6 inches, 7 inches long.
That's big. So it's ribbed. It's like ribbeted. Where'd you get it from? A sex toy store?
I bought it online.
From like what did you go to Adam and Eve or Adam Mail or?
I think it was Shop-Erotic.
Shop-Erotic, good for you.
Should I go there?
Those aren't even sponsors of ours, Jonathan. So you, how long ago did you buy it? How old were you? You were like a young gay man. You're like, I want
to. No. I had it like.
He bought it yesterday.
5 years. I don't know.
Discreet toys.
Not the same one. I over time I got a different one.
So how? Wait. A different one of the same one?
Similar, yeah.
The first one you bought was. So there's a history. Do you like how he's lying? He's just saying, "Oh, I bought one." So the first one you bought was 5 years ago, or is that the current one?
No, this is the second or third one.
But the first time you bought one was 5 years ago.
Yes.
How old were you?
Like early 30s.
Early 30s. How old are you now, John?
Yeah.
How old do you think I am?
I don't know, like, I thought you were like 30. Or like, no, actually, I don't know how old you are.
Question, is it like a hard thing or is it soft? I'm trying to find it.
Like, I don't even know how old Tori is. I think now I know.
It's just rubbery soft. It's not like super hard.
You know what a dildo feels like. Come on, Tori.
No. I'm trying to find it.
It's not like a metal thing. Yeah, usually the butt ones are a little bit softer.
A metal thing?
Is it like beady or is it just
ripped?
By the
way, where are you on vacation or on a trip that you're talking about your butt plugs right now?
I'm at my sister's in North Carolina.
Is she home?
Is she there? No. Are they listening?
She washing your butt plugs?
She's on her way to work listening.
So 5 years ago, you bought your first one. What did you use before that? Did you use like anything else to experiment? Like a thing? What have you used anything else? Or?
No.
Come on, Jonathan.
No, seriously.
No, like hot dogs or...
That's just you.
I was hoping I didn't tell that story already.
No, you want me to... I did not know...
You don't think Jonathan fed the hot dog to his cat afterwards?
Is it called a tushy teaser? Just wondering.
Could be.
So before then, you didn't try anything on a finger? You tried a finger. Come on, we all did.
No.
I've tried a finger.
Kind of.
So you've
but
tried.
I didn't realize what stimulating that would do to a person.
And what did you
to find, your asshole?
What did you find out?
I was really surprised.
Come in my burger.
Hey, come in my burger.
So I don't believe I.
I can't believe I said that.
I don't believe that Hunter hasn't, or what's his name, Jonathan. Who are you not dating that does a show? not inserted. See, what about now? Have you ever has a finger ever been inserted into your behind, Jonathan? Yours or another person's?
Yeah.
Iridescent butt plug.
Please, Tori. yours or another? Was it yours, Jonathan?
My own finger?
Yes.
Yeah.
I knew it.
You find this all fascinating. I think it's boring.
Anal ease cream. What the fuck is that?
Oh, come on. You know what that is.
This is just lube?
Jonathan, tell her what anal ease cream is. You know what it is.
Is it just lube?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, okay. Why does it have to have a special name then?
Because it's like a numbing agent.
Oh!
Mm-hmm.
That's not just lube. Sure, yeah, his cock is already out. Anal desensitizing cream. Oh. Great stuff. 5 stars.
Beef puts it on people and then they don't know he's fucking the shit out of them.
Do you need a massage? Oh. All right.
So
that sounds fun.
So after the toy, Jonathan, why would you start inserting your finger into your butt after you got the toy? Or was it before? See, I love how I can trick him.
Ass raspberry.
Well, probably before.
See, I love how Jonathan. Are you listening to this conversation? Jonathan lied 14 times on the show, and I tricked him every time. I had a conversation with my mom the other day because she voted for Trump, and I tricked her into. I was like, "Mom, you know you're." But I got her to admit that she was confused why she voted for him, and she was like, "Well, no, I understand." I'm like, "Mom, you just admitted it. I confused you." Like, I'm very good at that. I'm very good at confusing people.
You are, because most of the words you say aren't real.
Because I'm a perfect liar. I'm like the best liar, so I can get anything out of it. But what do you mean aren't real words? What do you mean? What was that? What was that comment?
Sometimes you just like you'll say something that doesn't really make a lot of sense.
Oh, exactly. Most of my sentences don't make sense to me. So before this, so when did you start inserting your finger into your butt, Jonathan? When you were like 15? Or?
Probably like 7.
7?
probably.
7?
No, more like teenage years.
Oh, damn it.
I knew a person, it wasn't me, that used a tampon.
What?
Kind of, you know, a lubed up a tampon. But the kind, the pearl kind, the nice kind with the plastic.
Yeah.
So, Ugh. I'm disgusting. One day I have so many stories. I can't get them all out now. One day, before I end the show, when we end the show in like 5 years, I will have told all my stories. I promise.
I'm trying to fuck your cousin.
What was that, Tori?
I'm pretty sure I did not say that. I'm trying to fuck your cousin.
It's disgusting.
I'm not trying to fuck your cousin.
There we go.
I'm trying to fuck your cousin. Oh my god! I'm not trying to fuck your cousin. I'm trying to fuck your cousin.
Oh.
Yeah. God damn it.
So many Tori sound effects. I love it.
Was that the episode where
with the bagpipes?
Yeah,
where you hear the bagpipes. Tori's so smart.
No, well, I was gonna expand, but then you interrupted me.
What did I expand? What do you mean?
Like, I was gonna ask if it was like the like Jesus guy who's like preaching.
The Jesus guy who got interrupted by the protesters.
Yes.
So Jonathan is inserting but that's honestly, if you insert Jonathan, I know you don't this because you do it, but if you insert something into your behind and you come, it's the greatest feeling ever for a man. The prostate stimulation. Is that right, Jonathan?
That's true.
Let's go. Spraying into the air. So while you're at your sister's, never mind, I don't care. Say it fast, please.
Visiting for the week, family, you know.
I love that I just asked you to say something so me and Trey could both take a drink. Thank God Jonathan's here. I'm going through these baby wipes like crazy too. I don't know why. I just feel like I keep touching sticky things.
Now you're just obsessed with using them.
They don't even like disinfect you, but I like that though because it's just like aloe and stuff. It's amazing. It's like a little sponge bath for your hands. And then if you put them on your lips a little bit too much, they actually numb your lips a little bit. It's weird. It's like a bad side effect. So then I have to dry them with paper towels. I got a whole process going on over here.
ASMR.
People think, oh, you know, it must be easy to talk, you know. Oh, good. What are you doing over there?
ASMR.
Hmm?
ASMR.
What?
ASMR.
Jonathan, help.
I don't know.
But what you had? I love how Jonathan turned his mic. Oh, did you forget to turn off your mic? Because I heard Jonathan just breathe.
I have a question.
Go ahead. You can just always ask your question, Jonathan. You don't need to breathe into the mic first and then ask your question.
I'll remember that. So you have this fleshlight over the weekend and you're using it. So where are you mounting it when you use it?
That's a good question.
It is a good question. On the wall.
Which, where? In your room?
On the office, yeah. Upstairs.
Upstairs? Okay.
Yeah.
Thank God.
Not
there's
down
no
here.
Hole in the wall?
No.
Have you ever recorded yourself?
Doing anything?
Yeah.
Oh, absolutely.
Really?
Mm-hmm. Oh, man. Well, I mean, I did a...
That freaks me out.
What? The fans are...
Not you doing it. Like, just the idea of
well,
it.
Well, here's the thing I noticed, too. Once I started doing the show, I could always, like, doing those scenes where you, like, go on those, like, random, like, chat roulette things. Mm-hmm. But there's, like, ones where, like, you basically go on and jerk off with people. I love that. But, you know, I don't show your face or anything. So I love that aspect of it. Mm-hmm. But ever since I started doing the show, I stopped doing that. Like, I think I did, like, once or twice. Just, like...
What if someone recognizes?
Well, no. You don't show your face or anything. Right. So you can if you want to mm-hmm. other people. It's just, you know, you can chat. But mm-hmm. I know I just like it because everyone goes on there and they're acting like they're not wanting to see other guys jerk off. And they get mad when I see a penis. But that's all that's on there is just mm-hmm. people jerking off. And it's kind of sucky, too, because it's mostly just fat guys. But once in a while, you'll find the guy who's been skipping all the fat guys. And then we'll hook up because mm-hmm. we look like twinks. So it's mm-hmm. we have such a fun time. And sometimes it'll be girls. And sometimes, you know, it'll be cool. I'll be like, hey, girls, look at my penis. But it's usually kind of awkward because they're usually, like, French. And they don't understand. They just like look at it like, ooh, blah, 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 penis. They never say,
hey, come in my burger.
So disappointing. But yeah, I would do, and I always had like a bunch of like cameras and stuff, so I would record myself, but then I would do it in like three camera shoot. So I would have like multi-camera, so you could like switch back and forth to them. Like, I didn't like live stream, but I had like three different positions, because I figure, why not? I had fun. I jerked off in a shower, because I was just like, why
was
not?
It ever like with anyone else or just alone?
No, I've never recorded videos, because I've had sex like three times. And I was so shocked that it was even happening. Yeah. Like, I didn't even know I was having sex before I was having sex. Like, you know, I couldn't manage all that.
You've had sex three times?
Jonathan, how many times have you had sex?
16.
Oh, my goodness.
That's it?
I love how he knows.
I don't know.
I think I've had sex over 100 times.
Well, yeah, but you've had with Hunter, the same person. Jonathan, have you actually counted 16 times, or you're just being funny?
I'm just being funny.
Ha ha ha.
Because you just go three times.
Sorry, I thought that was real funny, Jonathan. Jonathan, is
that makes me so uncomfortable.
So you're serious about the three times?
Jonathan, can you? I know it's potted down for you. Can you hear her laugh? Do you hear that when she laughs? Because it's kind of potted down for you. But do you hear it?
Yeah, I hear it.
All right.
I would definitely 100% believe that Ryan has only had sex three times.
Yeah, and I mean, no offense. I'm counting times I probably shouldn't even count, you know what I mean? Like, times that happen so fast, like stuff like that, but...
Like in the back of an Uber?
Four times.
Did that remind you of something?
No, because I was counting my head while I was trying to make a joke, but what did you say something about Uber? $15 off. This is me having sex in the back of an Uber. $15
What if you had sex in the back of an Uber? I feel like that's not allowed. Do you need a massage?
Do you need a massage?
Like, you would get one star, zero stars, negative stars.
There's no way that's real.
For doing that, right? I'm always thirsty. What? I'm always thirsty. Hey, come in my burger. I'm always thirsty.
But yeah, about four times, Jonathan. Couple with the same person, and then a couple, you know. What are you making noise with over there? Because I got Tori, we got new like new keyboards and stuff that are silent, but Tori's still managing to make noise over there. What are you doing over there?
I'm drawing a heart.
What's what?
A pen.
How do you make noise? Pens, they don't sell like silent pens.
I had to.
Oh, but no, I didn't hear that. I heard other noises.
I don't know.
Like, somehow Tori is managing to make every object make noise. What are those people that like make noise with cans? That's going to be you, but you do it with office
ASMR.
Supplies.
ASMR.
What is she saying, Jonathan? This is...
You know what ASMR is?
I don't know. It's like a band or something. Why are you doing this to me? Who do you think knows what ASMR is? Jonathan, do you know? Okay, stop. Jonathan, do you know what that means?
No, I don't. I don't think so.
AS what?
ASMR.
Not even the internet knows what that means. Yes. Anonymous sensory meridian response.
Yes, exactly.
What the fuck does that mean?
It's like, okay, so you know how people make videos?
Tori,
what? Like,
no, Tori. But this. Tori, why are you saying like letters and no one knows what they mean?
Because that's what it is.
But what is that? What is that?
You did it. You like took your paper towel and you like scrunched it up like this. And like the sounds like...
Hold on. Jonathan, why can't I hear you make noise?
Why do you sound like you're moaning?
Yes, why are you...
What noise?
You're like, ugh. Hey, come in my burger. Do you need a massage?
All right, thank you, Jonathan. But what are you doing over there? You're just staying where... never mind.
Can I explain it to you,
though? I guess. Can you do it, please, before
yes,
break? You gotta go to break
it.
In, like, 2 minutes.
Okay, so ASMR are, like, these videos where people, like, they whisper like this, and then they make comforting noises, and it's supposed to, like, calm you and...
Crazy.
...help you go to sleep. And I like the ones that aren't whispering, because I hate listening to people whisper, like, gives me anxiety, but I like just like it's like this, or like people will tap on stuff like this, or like this. You know, you gotta look it up. It helps you sleep pretty good.
I'm not trying
to fuck your cousin. No, I'm not.
Sorry, I wanted to play the other one. It's not labeled right at all.
I'm trying to fuck your cousin.
That's what I was trying to play. Editors, please.
Like this.
You have no idea what kind of time goes into making seamless loops of you laughing.
Well, I'm not doing it, so.
Almost seamless. Doesn't matter. I'm so glad we got Jonathan to admit that he stuck things up his butt.
Everyone stuck
stuff up their butt.
I love how he lied and said he didn't do it.
Right? I mean,
I'm on like my fifth baby wipe.
I want some cheese balls.
I have cheese balls upstairs.
I know.
They're so good. Go pour some on a plate and then come down here because we have like a 5-minute break.
It's like 30 seconds.
For me, it is. No, I have always like 10 minutes of stuff lined up, but I always interrupt it because I'm so excited to get back to the show. People are like, why is this break so large?
Why is it so large? Why does it have to be that big?
And I say, well, I have to go to the bathroom. And Tori asked me during the break.
Do you need a massage?
And I say, no, I do not, Tori.
Come in, let me suck on your fucking dick.
And like, Tori, we're co-workers. This is disgusting.
Yeah. God damn it.
It's my favorite one. It's her laughing and saying, God damn it.
God damn it.
That's an amazing woman.
I just want Ryan to play all these at my funeral.
No.
That was an awesome noise. Can we pull that, please?
Jonathan, you have to do that. Jonathan, how do you pull stuff? What have you pulled so far, Jonathan, for the show? Anything?
Probably me saying iridescent butt plug.
No, just different things. I don't know. I'm probably not even doing it right.
Tell me what you're doing. I want to know. So,
what she says for future clips, I guess.
This is the first week. Well, Jessica's on vacation for a week. And then she'll be gone in 2 weeks. So this is
this is such a good, like, this is such a bad episode for her to be gone, though. This is a great episode.
I know. And then we have to, I'm going to yell at her for, even though she's not here, because it's going to be so much funnier just to yell at her while she's not here. Trust me. But what was I even talking about? Please help me, Tori. This is ridiculous.
You're trying to get Jonathan to tell you what he's doing.
Well, no, she'll be gone in a few weeks. I'm so sad. Like, it's so nice having interns. It really is. Mm-hmm. I need to get someone that's in here full time, but I can't really afford to do it because usually we don't pay your interns. But I was like, Jessica's my cousin. I feel bad. And I know she probably wouldn't want to do it either unless she was getting paid. Mm-hmm. So she has like a 40-minute drive here.
Yeah.
Here and back. So she lives up in like very far. I'm going to miss Jessica. We have a Jessica song.
Are we going to have her sit in for the last episode?
I've been trying to get her to sit in once in a while for the news and stuff, but Berkshire might, I don't know, we have extra busy next couple weeks. I have a couple people that want to get in, and I'm like, I don't know, this is so fun.
Who?
I'm going to get my old weed guy to come in. I think it'd be interesting to talk to him.
Mm-hmm.
He went to our sister school.
Oh, okay.
So, but yeah. Jonathan, what are you doing over there? You gonna ask another question? Whenever I hear you, I'm gonna assume you're asking a question. So,
no, I'm fine, thank you.
So you just turned your mic on for what reason?
I don't know.
I love how I found the perfect amount of time to where it becomes funny, not funny, and then funny again. And it's what that time is? It's 7 seconds.
Listening to other people laugh just makes you laugh, and listening to yourself laugh makes you uncomfortable, so it's really weird.
When does Betsy come back?
Well, I'm not good enough, huh? I'm not good enough, Jonathan?
No, but no, you're great. It's just that she adds, you have good discussions with her.
Well, Jonathan, you're the arbiter, you're the producer, you should get her back on. I can only do so much, Jonathan.
Crazy.
Well, I'm not getting much of a budget to work with.
I'm trying to fuck your cousin.
That's my favorite. All right, Jonathan, mute yourself. We'll go to break. We'll come back. And we have a whole bunch of stuff to talk about, including everything we said we would talk about last week. Jessica did something horrible upstairs. I don't even think you know what it is. Don't check Twitter because I'm going to show you the picture. I had to tweet it, but don't check Twitter because it's a spoiler for the show.
Okay.
But I had to tweet it so that way I could have it on my
computer. I don't know what you're talking about.
I want to get that this week.
I'm just glad it wasn't me.
Yeah. We'll find out what happened on the ride home from Florida with Tori and Hunter.
Oh, I forgot about that.
Come in my burger.
And maybe we'll play a Tori song. Or no, we'll maybe play a Jessica song. So much. I'm going to miss Jessica.
So long. Farewell. Out for you saying goodbye. Oh my God. What is that from?
Well, that's Jessica.
So long.
You know that's...
So long, farewell,
little voice.
Out for you saying goodbye. So long, farewell. Out for you saying goodbye.
I hate to go and leave this pretty sight.
So long, farewell. Half a year say goodbye.
Adieu, adieu to you and you and you.
So long, farewell. Half a year say goodbye.
I'd like to stay and taste my first champagne.
Yes?
No.
So long, farewell. I'll hear you say goodbye.
I leave and heave a sigh and say goodbye. Goodbye.
Oh, beautiful. Wasn't that cute?
Mm-hmm.
All right, we'll come back and we'll have a whole bunch of fun. Singing for Troya, she's eating the cheese balls over there. No one can hear you. No, but I can't. I'm on mic and no one can hear what you're saying. Troy's eating cheese balls over there. Well, I gotta turn you on. There you go.
You need to get chopsticks. Because if you eat cheese balls with chopsticks, then you don't get it all over your fingers. Oh yeah, or gloves.
I have gloves. Well, your hands are already dirty.
No, they're not. I cleaned them off with a baby wipe.
I gave Tori with my gloves.
I feel like MJ.
I really like black like these like grippy gloves for work.
You see?
Then I wear them through the drive-thru and the guy was Todd's like, what are those driving gloves? I'm like, well, yeah, I'm a germaphobe. He's like, Germa, what? He's from Alabama. Germa, who?
How annoying is it going to be if I eat cheese balls on the mic?
Oh, incredibly. The fact that you even brought those in the studio is incredibly bothering me, but...
You told me to!
What'd you just say again with yourself you did? Give me a second, guys. Let's get into this. I love these fake comeback for breaks we do. I'm over here standing up. Standing up for all the ladies. Look how lengthy I am. I'm so gross. Gotta move the cameras away from me immediately. Once there was not even matching. Okay. Red's green on.
Show me your dick.
Jonathan, are you there? Jonathan.
Yes, I'm here.
What did you just write down?
Show me your dick.
At what time?
11:42.
It's going to have a Beatles melody in the background. I bet, but who cares? That was Slash coming out of the break, and this is a Beatles medley from The Counting Crows, 2012. To get back home.
Do I have cheese ball dust on my face?
I don't know, does she, Jonathan?
Can't yes. see me. No, I don't.
No, I don't. Say goodbye. Whoa.
Come in, my burger.
Hey, come in my burger. I can't wait to tell Hunter later that he has a sound clip.
Mm-hmm.
No.
No, you don't.
No. No.
No.
No. No. Is that me?
Mm-hmm.
Doesn't that sound like me? No. No.
I just need new ones. I think it's it. I think you got through them all. I'm always thirsty.
I'm always thirsty. I'm always thirsty.
I love that one. I just love the cadence of it.
I'm always thirsty.
You're gonna carry that weight.
Crazy.
Carry that weight. Back home.
God damn it. Boy,
you're gonna carry that weight.
I don't know if I like this.
The song?
No, this medley.
Oh, that's what I meant. Song medley. Medley. Medley.
I love this, the original song.
Well, you pay the rates for Beatles, why don't you? I don't see you footing the bills for any of these things. I was pooping this morning. No, I squat over the toilet, and I was noticing my cat rest. He was kind of doing the same thing. He was kind of shaking, and I didn't realize he was shitting on my carpet while I was shitting at the same time. So then I had to get up and then push him over so he'd stop shitting. And then we're both with asses full of duty, and then I threw his duty with toilet paper on top of my duty. Mm. And I'm like, I didn't even finish pooping, so I had to flush it, and I'm like gagging and puking. It's awful. Then on top of the chafed dick thing, it was horrible. I'm all wet. Ugh.
Mm. Why?
Who, me?
No, it's like I've been outside. It's so gross. Everything about me, just not good. There's nothing good about me. My hands are dry, too. I can't do a show like this. Let me get some lotion. I'm very prepared, though, for the show. I have everything in the studio.
Mm-hmm. A lighter.
I have Q-tips. Do I have a lighter in here?
Mm-hmm.
I actually ran out of lighters because I stopped actually smoking weed. Do a different thing now.
Yeah, crack.
I do some crack. You still need a lighter for that.
Coke.
My hands are all lotioned. It's so nice. What was I saying,
What's though? The difference between crack, coke,
Jonathan?
And cocaine? Or is coke and cocaine the same thing?
Help us find out that out, Jonathan. We should know the difference. It's in some type.
I don't know from experience.
We should be typing. Who's texting you, by the way? Do you have friends? Or is that some dick on the phone?
Who, me? It's not me. It's another phone.
Who's near you? Oh, so you can't be inappropriate now? Are you by your sister?
No, it's my sister's MacBook I'm using.
Oh.
And I guess it's her text. I don't know.
Ooh, what does the text say? Read it. Does it say,
come in my burger?
Is it from Hunter and does it say, come in my burger? Message from Hunter.
Come in my burger.
I don't know.
Message from Tori.
I'm trying to fuck your cousin.
Yeah. Hunter's having a thing with my sister.
I'm trying to fuck your cousin.
It sounds like you're actually saying it too. It's so good. We have great editors.
I'm trying to fuck your cousin. Is it you?
Yes. I'm very good at what I do.
Oh, man.
I gotta remember not to interrupt your real laugh that I could pull with fake laughter.
Yeah.
so I can pull all these. And I got to set up the system where it just automatically just records your mic. It just, but I'm going to get a feed where I can just record your mic no matter what it is. So that way when I pull it, it'll just be clean audio. It won't have any of me under it. So no matter if I'm talking over you, because it was a good clip last week, but I was talking over you. But it's a stern trick. They isolate every single channel, so that no matter what someone says, it doesn't matter. It's just always there. It's great for Robin in the booth, though, because it's just pure laughter because she's, like, isolated. That's what I need for you. I need you to be isolated. Because you'd still hear me on your mic. Oh, that's what I need to do. I need to build glass in the studio. What was I getting into? I don't even know. Yeah, so...
Me either.
Well, no, we were, like, cleaning up last week, me and Jessica, the intern. My cousin, the intern. And, We set out like a bunch of different Oreos, like two or three different kinds of Oreos. And then I just kind of had Oreos off to the side that were like unopened. They're kind of like hidden too. So I was like cleaning up, and then I'm like, Jessica was saying something, but I'm like laughing because I'm looking at the scene of Oreos, and I put it on the, I actually loaded it into the video system because I wanted to make sure that in future time I would still have this. Don't look at my screen. Wait for me to put it on the screen because I'm just getting things set up. But I go and see. Let's see if I can show it. I go and see this. Can you see that? It might be better to look behind you.
What the hell?
Wait, hold on. I have two different pictures. I don't know how to switch.
Oh my god!
I don't know how to switch the pictures. So hold on. Well, I don't know how to do this. Well, I tried it before the show too, and I was able to switch it. Hold on. I can go this way. Hold on. Oh, is it this one? Oh, there it is.
Yeah, it's like completely like ripped open.
So you know how there's like a tabby thing?
Yeah.
This entire thing of Oreos is ripped apart. Ripped to shreds.
Is that the one that wasn't open?
It was the one that was completely unopened. Oh, and I'm like, God. Jessica, oh my God, we're going to have to fire Tori. Because I thought it was you. And then she like looks at me and she goes, yeah, that was me. And I'm like, Jessica, what the fuck happened? I was so fucking angry.
I can't believe that, first of all, you blamed it on me, and second of all, that she actually, like, came clean and told you it was her.
Well, I'm just like, Jessica, what, you were just gonna leave these? And then, well, here's the thing that, what she said, though, and this, I wrote it down because I was shocked. This is what she said, quote, and she was kind of saying it kind of like, I guess the cadence doesn't matter, but I'll just have to say it. Honestly, I kind of forgot about it. I had other things on my mind.
Oh! All right.
She, and here's the thing. She, I was like, Jessica, when were you planning on like, could you like not throw it in a bag or something? I was so like fucking like rooted out by it, by these Oreos that she just like torn apart. And now it's like, I mean, I shouldn't complain, but like, it's one of those scenes where, you know, if like you leave Oreos out on like a hot summer day,
they get stale.
They all taste like day old hot. Mm-hmm. So the entire thing of Oreos is just gross.
Mm-hmm.
And I mean, I'm not some big shot. I can afford a $3 thing of Oreos,
mm-hmm.
But you just leave Oreos out in the middle of the fucking kitchen. Like, what kind of elitist attitude is that? Like, why am I like your fucking mommy? And I guess she said the thing is she like tried to open it normally and it just ripped open. But I don't understand. Probably.
I mean, that makes sense.
Maybe, I guess. But I've never had an Oreo incident. I just want to point that out.
Poor Jessica.
Aren't you angered by this? I thought you'd be more angered.
I mean, I can understand how...
I can understand an Oreo incident.
Like, how you can accidentally, like, tear it open like that. But to not tell you, I mean...
For the audio listeners, I tweeted it out today. Yeah. I was shocked. Thank God she's leaving in 2 weeks. So glad she's going to be gone.
She's so long. Farewell. Out for your saying goodbye.
Good riddance. What the fuck? It's so. I was going to get her like a nice going away present, but she fucking tore open my Oreos.
Watch her like come next week with a brand new pack of Oreos.
She won't.
I will.
You will for it, just to make up for it?
Are they double stuff?
They are double stuff. Right. You seriously don't want to get her a vibrator for her last day?
No.
Jonathan, don't you think that's hilarious?
I feel like it will make her feel uncomfortable.
Well, yeah.
And I don't want to
hilarious.
Bingo. What did you, Jonathan, what was that noise? All that noise, and you said hilarious. What was that? Tori's rubbing the table. You're saying hilarious. The whole show is fucked up.
Well, I mean, I don't know. I mean, isn't that the standard thing? You give it to anybody no matter what.
Well, you gave it to yourself.
Well, nobody can give it to yourself like yourself can.
Jonathan, write down 11:52. Tori moans kind of oddly, so write that down. I love hearing him type away.
Yeah, and then when I'm done with this thing, what do I do with it?
You throw it away. Delete it. No, you send it to me.
How?
You can send... Oh, my God. You can send iCloud notes. You send it. There's a little... can you not ask me this on the show? Johnny's like, how do I fill out the form for the 412K?
Oh, well, just send it in the mail.
Just mail it out. Mail it out, Jonathan. So funny, Jonathan is. I love him.
Mm-hmm.
This is Jonathan's favorite sound effect, the come in my burger one.
Come in my burger?
Jonathan loves Hunter.
Hunter saying it?
Yeah, Jonathan loves Hunter. Isn't that right,
I'm John? Sure he fucking does, because everyone loved Hunter.
Loved, duh.
And then Hunter left.
Do you need a massage?
Massage?
You're saying it, not me. Alright, are we done with Jonathan? I mean, we're not done with Jonathan, but...
For now.
Come in my burger.
Come in my burger. Hey, come in my burger.
I love I have a silent mouse now. It's amazing.
So do I.
We can't hear each other click anymore. It would bother me. You'd be talking. I would just hear... Professionals.
Come in my burger.
Come.
Hey, come in my burger. Why did I say it like that? Hey, come in my burger.
It was hey, and then I said something. So I cut out what I said, and then I... So it's you saying hey... And I said something, and he said, come in my burger. Mm-hmm. We were talking about a news thing. And then Hunter said it, because I couldn't get you to say it again cleanly. It's crazy.
Crazy.
All right.
Hey.
Oh, my God. I didn't, because I was working on other things, like Tori songs, or what's her name? Katie's, or what's her name? The person who's an intern.
Jessica
songs. Would you like to hear a repeat of a Tori song?
Me?
Or do you just want to go right into the news?
Sure.
What song? Which one would you like to hear? Which one's your favorite? You always have favorites. Do you remember all of them? We have so many of them. Do you remember what the first Tori song was?
Who Let the Air Bud Out?
It was... I actually have to look it up. I actually don't know if I have it written down anywhere. Hold on, I can tell you. I had to go into a different system though. Hold on. Actually, I think it was... Actually, I know what it was. I just gotta see which one it is. It's not this one.
That didn't make any sense.
No, I just have to look because I have two versions of that one. I remember. My name is... It's this one.
Oh, yeah.
My name is... My name is... My name is...
Air Bud.
My name is... My name is... My name is...
Air Bud.
My name is...
Excuse me.
My name is...
Air Bud.
Can I have the attention of the class for 1 second?
My name is
Air Bud.
Hi, kids. Do you like violence? Yeah, wanna see me stick 9-inch nails to each one of my eyelids?
Uh-huh. Have you ever seen a movie where the dog is plays soccer?
My brain's dead weight. I'm trying to get my head straight, but I can't figure out which Spice Girl I want to impregnate.
Maybe babies should never be
born. Shady, you a basic. So why's your face red, man? You wasted.
Well, since age 12, I felt like I'm someone else.
I want them to know.
My original self from the top bunk with a belt. Got pissed off and ripped Pamela Lee's tits off and smacked her so hard I knocked her clothes backwards like crisscross. I smoke a fat pound of grass and fall on my ass faster than a fat bitch who sat down too fast. Slut, Shady, wait a minute, that's my girl, dawg. I don't give a fuck, God sent me to piss the world off.
My name is...
What? My name is who? My name is...
Air Bud.
Hi. My name is... My name is... My name is...
Air Bud.
Hi. My name is... Beautiful.
My name is... My
Air Bud.
My name is my name is my name is
Air Bud.
Boo-doop. A boo-doop. Tori, please.
I want them to know.
I was waiting.
I want them to know. I want them to know. I want them to know. I want them to know.
I'm trying to fuck your cousin. A U.S. soldier.
I want them to know. I'm trying
journey.
To. Wait, hold on.
I want them to know.
I'm trying to fuck your cousin.
I want them to know. I'm trying to fuck your cousin.
I want them to know. 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 I want them to know.
The U.S. Army soldier took a deep breath before hitting the button that sent the email to more than 200 fellow troops. All considered, I am and have been traversing what is essentially a personal matter, but it's something I must address publicly. The email started. I am transgender. The April 13th email officially ended the secret that burned inside Captain Jennifer Sims, who was known as Jonathan Sims, but the feeling of relief swiftly turned to unease last week after President Donald Trump tweeted that transgender people were no longer welcome in the U.S. military. I read the tweets while I was at work, and you know it was devastating because I still have work to do, and here I am reading basically what sounds like the President of the United States, who is the Commander-in-Chief. He is the ultimate boss of the military, telling me and anybody else that is transgender that we are fired. Let me suck on your fucking dick.
No, Tori, they don't have those anymore.
No.
No.
Should it be president?
I love when you're so angry about the president.
Should it be president?
No chaos.
We should build a wall.
Trump insists as he swears in new chief of staff.
Ooh, sexy.
Hoping to turn the page on a tumultuous opening chapter to his presidency, President Donald Trump insisted on Monday there is no chaos in his White House as he swore in retired Marine General John Kelly as his new chief of staff.
No.
In an Oval Office ceremony, Trump predicted Kelly, who previously served as Homeland Security Chief, would do a spectacular job, and the president chose to highlight the rising stock market and positive jobs outlook rather than talk about how things might need to change in his White House under Kelly. Trump on Friday ousted Vince Priebus as Chief of Staff.
Vince Priebus.
And turned to Kelly, who he hopes will bring military discipline to an administration weighed down by a stalled legislative agenda, infighting among West Wing aides and a stack of investigations.
Beautiful, beautiful. What's the president got to do? Get some of that pussy.
Remember when he called you?
Wonderful, wonderful, Hank. What question? When was the last time you masturbated?
I fucking hate Donald Trump.
Remember he said he welcomed you back that one day?
Yeah, I remember.
That was great.
Hello, and I must start off by welcoming back Tori.
Where the hell have you been? When was the last time you masturbated? What's a president got to do to get some of that pussy?
Beautiful, beautiful. What's a president got to do to get some of that pussy?
All right, Tori.
I want them to know. I want them to know. I want them to know.
There's a fine one that I haven't read already.
There's go to the back of the deck or whatever.
That's what
I said. A bunch of new ones. A whole bunch of new ones for Tori to do.
I want them to know. I want them
a
to
woman
know.
Tells the cops her friend sold her spider eggs instead of crack. I already read that one.
I hate spider eggs.
It's like a way back here. A dude plays dress up to hide from the cops. A guy in Florida with a warrant tried to hide from the cops last week by dressing like a woman, but the dude didn't really look like a lady. In fact, he just looked like Steven Tyler from Aerosmith, and the cops quickly tracked him down and arrested him. Three coworkers busted doing something dirty at work.
Ooh.
Get back to work, you slacker.
Three coworkers were busted last week for having a threesome in broad daylight on the back porch of a restaurant in Mississippi. They're all facing indecent exposure charges. Oh my god.
Have you ever done that?
No. Arby's is now selling pizza sandwiches.
Yeah.
If you thought Arby's roast beef and liquid cheddar were the most unholy things they could put on a sandwich,
give
what the
fuck? Give me some sweet liquid.
Well, you just underestimated Arby's. Their latest creation is pizza sliders. Yes, Arby's is now in the pizza game. The sliders have pepperoni, salami, provolone cheese, and marinara sauce on a bun, and they'll be on sale through the end of next month. Gross.
That's good.
A drunk driver crashes into the sheriff's brand new drunk driving awareness car. A drunk driver in Florida crashed into a car on Saturday night, and it happened to be a brand new sheriff department's car that was covered in drunk driving awareness messages. He was arrested for a DUI.
That's... what's that called, Tori?
Driving under the influence?
No, it's called irony.
Oh. Florida man urinates in neighbor's mailbox during dispute. Wow. I wish you could show the picture of this guy.
What's it look like?
Terrible. Looks like someone who would pee in your mailbox. A dispute between two neighbors goes bad when one decided to urinate in the other's mailbox after the cops were called on him for playing music too loudly. A 44-year-old man called the police to report that one of his neighbors was playing music too loudly. Police showed up and asked the neighbor to keep the volume down. This request angered the neighbor playing the music. That's when he walked into the street, pulled his pants down, pointed his middle finger at the man who called the cops, and then urinated in his mailbox. Wow.
I don't know why I can't find the pee sound effect. I used to know exactly where that was. Oh. To my last page. Oopsies. Oh my goodness, Troy. We have so much fun here.
We do.
Do a little bit more.
I'm trying to find one from our
sex bank.
I want them to know. 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 I want them to know.
Oh my god. Man spits on driver on Hall Road.
Oh, gross.
That's right down the street, isn't it?
Yep. On December 14th, in the area of Hall and Heidenreich, that's like right by my house.
Thanks for telling everyone, Tori.
A motorist turned onto eastbound Hall
address?
Road and cut off a white work van. The driver of the van then allegedly sped in front of the vehicle, slammed on his brakes, and exited his vehicle. He allegedly walked up to the vehicle that cut him off and said, "You cut me off. You could have fucking killed me." The driver of the vehicle that cut the man off spit on the man and drove off. The license plate was recorded and came back to a Macomb Township man. At press time, the Macomb Township man was sought for assault and battery. Damn.
Is that him spitting?
Yeah.
I love our beautiful city.
I want them to know. I want them to know.
Man caught huffing from aerosol can. On January 19th at Sunoco, in the 3400th block of Harper Avenue... I know where that is.
Two witnesses.
It's not that far. It's like 10 minutes away. A man allegedly inhaled chemical agents from an aerosol can while sitting in the parking lot. The witness reportedly knocked on the man's car window, but he didn't respond. Police arrived and arrested the man, 37, for narcotics possession. Oh, maybe that was my stepdad.
Oh, your dad did some fun stuff, didn't he?
Stepdad. Ex-stepdad.
Tori, stepdad, are you in there?
Yoo-hoo, baby!
Ooh, yeah! Ooh, yeah!
I want them to know.
I want them to know. I want them to know. I want them to know. I want them to know.
This one's for hire. I was just dancing in the dark.
Man banned from store for stealing. On March 5th at Meyer in the block of Grosbeck Highway, loss prevention called police when a known suspect was allegedly concealing merchandise in his black backpack while riding the store's motorized scooters. Loss prevention told police the man had been caught stealing before and he was not allowed to return to any Meyer location. The man, 48, was arrested for trespassing and retail fraud.
Oh my God, such a good song. Don't you love this?
Yes.
Papa.
I want them to know.
Beautiful.
One more?
Do what you do, Toy. You know what to do.
One, two. You know what to do.
I want them to know.
Okay. I'm always thirsty.
That's the news.
I'm always thirsty. Police looking for suspect in alleged abduction attempt.
Alleged.
At press time, the Fraser Department of Public Safety was asking residents across all of Macomb County to be wary of a suspect allegedly involved in an abduction attempt. The incident occurred around 6 p.m. May 2nd. An 11-year-old Fraser boy was walking down Richard Street near 13 Mile and Hayes when he was allegedly approached by an unknown individual. Fraser police stated that a white man in his 30s wearing sunglasses and a beanie on his head pulled up in a vehicle. He's like, what's up, dude?
Awesome.
The suspect allegedly told the boy awesome. That his mother had been in an accident and that awesome. He needed to jump inside his vehicle. Awesome. A regular cab white pickup truck with aftermarket alloy wheels and a scratch on the rear driver's side fender.
Sick ride, dude.
And awesome. Go to the hospital.
Awesome.
Okay, first of all, kids nowadays know that that shit is not fucking real. Like, they're literally taught to be like, if anyone comes up to you and says, I'm in an accident, don't believe them. So how fucking stupid are you?
My mom didn't teach me any of that shit.
Well, I mean, like, now.
School, they taught you that.
Kids now. Anyways, the boy was able to run away from the suspect and make it home. Fraser Lieutenant Mike Petees said said the boy was at a friend's house a few houses down from where he lives with his mother and father. The suspect telling the boy his mom was in an accident scared the boy and he ran off.
Did you just die?
It's like, I don't know. Yes, I did. And the truck sped off northbound and wasn't seen again, PD said. The boy's mother was fine, confirming the suspect's lie to lure the boy. PT said the boy's father is the one who called the police, as there were no known witnesses. A press release described the situation as an abduction attempt, and PT said an officer at the scene spoke with the boy and his father confirmed what happened.
Give me a kiss.
We take all abduction attempts seriously, and we have to take the boy at his word, PT said. That's always a concern. That the story is made up. But there's no information that would indicate that this did not happen.
We actually have audio of the guy who abducted the kid right now.
Come in my burger.
And actually had a woman with her, and she said,
I'm trying to fuck your cousin. Petey's admitted the suspect's
Hunter said,
come in my burger.
It's vague. I'm trying to fuck. He wants people who may know or can identify the suspect to contact authorities immediately.
Imagine the abductor is you and Hunter.
Anyone with information related to the suspect or the attempt is asked to call Fraser Police.
Car pulls up.
I'm trying to fuck your cousin.
Come in my burger.
It's like, I'm calling the police. I'm 12. Don't ask me to come in my burger.
Come in my burger.
I'm trying to fuck your cousin.
This
he
dick
whipped
out.
Out the dick. Let me suck on your fucking dick.
What's the other one? Oh, cock's already out.
Sure, yeah, his cock is already out. Bite that scrotum, lady. I'm always thirsty. No. Do you need a massage?
Oh, no, that's what he said. Troy said. Hunter said.
Come in my burger.
And Troy said.
Do you need a massage?
Poor little boy. All right, Tori, anything else?
Nope.
All right, what did we learn? Anything?
Don't listen to men in white trucks who wear beanies.
Do you need a massage?
Do you need a massage? All right, thank you, Tori. Thank you, Jonathan. And thank you.
Listeners.
The person.
We love you.